What's going on, YouTube? It's your boy, Majay, and I'm back with another video. You guys requested, so here it is. Rodney Carrington, part one. Before we get into the video, make sure you guys like, subscribe. Let's go.
I turned to one of them, and I said, is that a good place to be? And the guy says, no, if you need to take a shit, it is. And I had to, so it worked out real good. Of course, I played the next 17 holes without any socks on, but I didn't have a golf towel. Then I got back and I got a massage, which I love, which I don't do that often, but I don't understand the whole concept of a massage. You get a woman to rub all over every single part of your body, except the one part you really won't rub, no.
I didn't think about that. That is a good point. I never thought about that. Wow. It's just, wow. Comedians are smart. Let's go.
It's not like she didn't know what part I was talking about. I kept pointing at it, clearing my throat. She just left. Oh my God. We did a television show for 2 years on ABC. It was called Rodney. Did you see that? Yeah. I'm going to tell you a little bit about what it was like. As I live up in Tulsa, and they called me, and of course, I went out to California. I went out there, and I got there the first week, and they said, you're going to be in this big parade at Disneyland, all the stars of ABC. You know, and I'm all excited. And I get out there and I get out of the car. They give me this big sash with my name on it. Then they stick me in this room with all these famous people, real famous people, like all the Desperate Housewives. And I'm like, shit. You know, and then I notice that I'm the only sumbitch in there with a sash on.
What's a sash? What's a sash? Is it like an old version of a... Is it like a satchel? Is that what you mean? Like a satchel? I think I know what a satchel is because of the movie Tangled. But is that what he's talking about? But anyway.
I said, hey, where's y'all sash at? And some lady in there goes, they don't need a sash. People know who the hell they are.
Well, dang.
And they gave me this guide at Disneyland. I got to walk to the front of every line. You get your own damn TV show, you ain't waiting in line. They'll walk your ass right to the front. And my kids thought that was the coolest thing in the world. They were going, Daddy, this is great. We don't have to wait in line, nothing. I said, well, don't get too cocky, because if they throw that show off there, we're getting back that damn line again. The problem with walking past everybody in line is that they've been standing there for 2 hours, and they don't particularly care for that shit. True. I told that guy, I said, at least they could have done is give us a wrench and a flashlight, so it looks like we're going up there to fix some shit. These people are pissed. You know, it might work if you walk past them and you're Madonna, then everybody goes, oh my God, it's Madonna! Oh my God! You know, it don't work when you're me, you know. Where the fuck are you going? So we're just going to go up here and fix some stuff. She said, what about them kids? I go, they got cancer, bitch, for God's sakes.
Oh my goodness!
Turkey leg, shut up.
Oh my goodness! Are the lines at Disney World really that bad? I've never been to any amusement park ever. Are the lines at Disney World really that bad? For those who have been, please let me know, because, like I said, I've never been.
My wife had never been out there, and she came out, and she wanted to go shopping in Beverly Hills because she'd seen it on the Travel Channel. We got this car that they provided us with, and there was this driver who was a real pompous ass. You know, I'm looking at the map. I said, take us to Rodeo Street. He says, it's Rodeo. I said, whatever, asshole-ayo, let's just go. We got down there, and I bought her a shoe because I couldn't afford the other one. They don't fuck around on Rodeo Street.
Now you got a present for Christmas.
We went in that Ralph Lauren shop. He's awful proud of his shit, isn't he? He had a sweater in there for $600. You get a sweater at Walmart for $13. He had a sweater for $600. I asked this Spanish fella, I said, how come this sweater $600? He said, it's cashmere. Now let me, this son of a bitch jumped toward me like that. I thought he was going to fuck me. I did.
What? He said it's Kashmir.
But he didn't. He didn't, see? He said, well, it might be Kashmir, but the price is bullshit. That scared him because he thought I was going to fuck him, but I didn't. And we went to this restaurant out there to eat. It's a real fancy place. And I think that's the name of it, real fancy place. And we went in, and I couldn't read the menu because it's written in some sort of foreign language. And I asked the waiter, I said, I can't read this shit. What do you recommend? And he says, the fish balls. Now, fish balls at this place were apparently like a hush puppy with fish in it. But when he first said it, I was thinking what you were thinking. Fish balls, I'm going to have to eat a million of those to get full. You ever seen the balls on a fish? They're tiny.
I was even thinking, wait, do fish have testicles? This episode is really opening my eyes. Do fish have testicles? Or how do fish reproduce? Do they just swim and just drop sperm wherever they swim at? Is that what we're drinking in the ocean when you accidentally swallow ocean water? Oh my gosh.
You better bring me a whole bunch of them damn things. He just rolled his eyes and walked away. I said, throw in a chicken deck while you're at it. Chicken deck and fish balls on a bed of lettuce. Bring some ketchup. You can make anything taste good with ketchup. They got some weird shit out there. We went in this bar one night, me and my buddy Nick, and there was a fella in there, and he was gay, and I knew he was because he was wearing a t-shirt, said he was. Which I appreciate because you could spot him. And there he is right there. And I'd cut out a lot of bullshit if we all had a t-shirt, said what we liked on there. I mean, if I had a t-shirt with a big puss, he could see that, and I could say, see, I like that, you like this, and this just ain't going to work, you just keep on walking. See? So we got back in this back room, me and this guy, Nick, we were playing pool, and Nick left me there. We had one of them uncomfortable moments where you laugh and shut up and then lock eyes, but he locked a little too long, you know. He was like, he says, you know, Rodney, I like you. I said, well, hell, I like you too. He says, you ought to try it. And I said, try what? He said, being gay. I said, I don't think that's something you try. You don't try a dick. You try ice cream. See, at least with ice cream, you taste it, you don't like it, you walk away. There's no long-lasting effect. But I'm almost certain if I tried dick that that would affect me for the rest of my life.
Oh my goodness. It's funny, but it's like, sir, you're going to get my channel taken down and I didn't have nothing to do with it. But it's just, wow, it's crazy how back then you could say certain stuff. And now, if you used to say this today, oh yeah,
cancel. Cancel. Everything deleted. Everything gone.
But anyway.
I don't think I'd ever have fun ever again. I'd be on a roller coaster with my buddy. Woo! Ain't this great, Rodney? Yeah? I should have never tried that there. Maybe you should have put ketchup on it. Oh, hell. Everybody kept saying when we were out there, you gotta go to the San Diego Zoo. That's the greatest zoo in the world. And we went, and that's bullshit. Too much walking. The animals are too goddamn far apart. I told my wife, I said, I need to make it more exciting. You know, take a Slim Jim, stick it in the ass of a death row inmate, and have him run through that lion cage without getting bit.
What?
See if he can make it.
I mean, I guess if he's on death row, but I like Rodney Carrington. His jokes are funny. I like the way that he acts out some of his jokes too, but it's just, it's just wild how you just can't say certain things now. Because if he was to make that joke today, it'd probably be, I mean, people in the crowd would probably laugh, but he would probably be all over Breakfast Club, all over Twitter, all over social media. But hey, good thing he said in the era that he was in. Anyway, that's going to be it for my reaction, guys. If you like this reaction, make sure you like, comment, share, subscribe, and I'll be back with you guys next time. I'm out.